Justin hurt himself making toast the other day.
Scott, just say it now.
We're going to Ron in Texas.
Just in case anybody missed it, one more time. How did I hurt myself?
You were making toast, but you also were trying to do some sort of, what do you call that?
A hurricane kick.
Acrobatic stretch to close the fridge and pop the back out. But you said Ron in Texas.
Yeah, I want to go to this guy.
He's holding.
Misha does a great job of getting your name, where you're from, and a little bit about your story. And the first one that jumped off the screen to me was Ron, not just because he's got a pretty funny story by the sounds of it. Ron, are you in Texas right now, man?
Yes, sir, I am. How you guys doing?
How you holding up, brother? What takes you to the Lone Star State?
I moved to Maryland, saw my mom and dad down here about 7 years ago, so I'm an old Calvert County boy, so living the dream down here.
Well, we're glad
Where
to
in
have
Texas
you.
Are you?
Well, right now we're based just north out of San Antonio, but I traveled to Corpus Christi and all the way down to South Texas.
You ever go to El Paso?
No, I won't go there.
No, it's bad, right? Juarez.
Did
is
you
like,
fight in the Alamo?
Yes. Thank you for fighting off the Mexican army so many centuries ago. Okay, so I just see. How did you hurt yourself eating soup?
Okay, so I was down south at South Padre Island, which is about 200 miles south of Corpus, where I lived at the time. And I was meeting some of my guys that worked for me, and we went to a Chinese restaurant. And I leaned over to take a sip of miso soup, and my back went out right at the table. So I let the guys know I was in very bad pain. I literally crawled to my truck, helped myself in the truck, and drove 200 miles with my leg out the window, leaning over my console, looking with one eye over the dashboard. And I did get stopped.
Oh, my God.
I got stopped by the Texas State Patrol. He asked me what the hell I was doing. I told him, and he laughed at me. He says, good luck. Long story short, about 6 months later, I had surgery, and now I'm doing better.
Oh, my God. You leaned over to take a sip of soup, and then it just goes out on you. Ron, that was worth the hold, buddy. Take care. Glad you're flying the flag in Texas. Let's go to Brian in Dundalk. Has been holding for a little bit. Brian, thank you for your patience. What's the dumb way you hurt yourself?
All right. So when I was a kid, probably around 8 or 9, like most parents, they took me to the circus and had a great time. Next day, my dumb ass decides to try to tightrope walk across the top rail of my chain link fence. Fell and broke my ankle.
I thought you were going to say you smashed your nuts on the fence.
I broke each of my legs one at a time.
That's hilarious.
That is really funny. I mean, how many kids, thank you for the call, buddy. How many kids just emulate something that they see in a film? They're watching Indiana Jones. They grab their dad's leather belt. They try and swing from a chandelier. And then the next thing you know, the chandelier is on the floor and most of it's embedded in their head. Before I take the rest of these calls, Josh, going to you, man. What can you recall a time when you were younger, or hell, I mean, in modern times, you're like, you can't believe you hurt yourself like that.
Yeah, the only thing I can think of is I've gone to the bathroom and while reaching for toilet paper, I've
oh my God,
I've pulled a muscle in my arm.
We're not long for this world.
We are not. I joked with the chiropractor yesterday, 200 years ago, I wouldn't have made it through an even mild winter. And Scott, you had the one coming down the steps, right, where you just basically brained yourself? What was the one? How'd you
coming
hurt yourself?
Down the steps?
Maybe I'm thinking of someone else. I remember you hurt yourself really bad. Oh, no, your chin. You did something to your chin. What'd you do to your chin?
I mean, I split my chin open, but that wasn't really. We were racing bikes.
Oh, that's.
So I don't know how dumb that was.
No, that's pretty standard.
Yeah,
that's pretty standard. Oh, that's right. I'm thinking of Pete. Pete was running down the stairs of my best friends from Waldorf because his mom made pancakes, and he ran down the stairs with such speed that the little overhang lip above the stairs.
Oh yeah.
Just caves his skull in, completely caved in his head, full concussion, and had to be taken to the hospital. And by the time he got back, the pancakes were gone. Let's go to Keith in Dundalk. I've got 5 calls here. 4 of them are in Dundalk. Let's go to Keith. What's up, buddy?
What's up, guys?
How you doing, bud?
I crushed 2 discs in my back taking a dump. I went to pull my pants off when I was done and crushed 2 discs. Now, I don't know if that's exactly how I did it, but I went to the chiropractor and this little 4 foot tall, beautiful blonde, I think she almost paralyzed me. She had hands like a gorilla.
Oh, so you went to pull your pants up and just completely blew your back out?
Blew my back out. Crushed two discs. I wound up having two back surgeries.
Oh, just because of a dump.
That's the worst.
Because of a dump. We got some here at JSS98Rock on Twitter. This one's great. There was a spider in my lap, so I punched it. Completely crushed their own balls. Just, there's a spider on their crotch. And then just completely take the wind out of themselves. Vanessa, broke my toe playing hacky sack, missed the sack, kicked barefoot full speed the arm of a couch dead center of a 2x4. I was out of the gym for 2 months. You're playing hacky sack. Our old friend Barb, she gave herself a black eye answering the phone. She just put the phone to her head so quickly, she completely smashed herself in the head. God, that's funny. Chuck, the wife got up in the middle of the night, tripped over the dog, smacked her head on the door frame, knocked herself out, concussion and whiplash. Oh, my God, these are great. Who else we got that's been holding for a second here? Jimmy and Gambrels, what's been going on with you, buddy? What's the dumb way you hurt yourself?
Hey, it was a week before my Army graduation, and we were cleaning our barrels of our rifles before we turned them back in, and I was pulling the cleaning rod through the barrel and it slipped and I hit myself in the face and gave myself a black eye.
Oh,
that sucks.
Yeah, texter says, oh yeah, I could only imagine.
Could have been
somebody
worse.
Says they were brushing their teeth and they bent over to spit out the toothpaste and knocked out their front tooth on the faucet.
Oh, it's so rough. Dave, I stood up from the toilet. The seat stuck to my ass, caught me off balance. So when I sat back down, my ween tip got smashed between the seat and the toilet bowl, crushing my... Oh!
Ow!
Oh, God!
Penis. Say penis.
Penis.
Louder.
Texter.
Penis.
Blew my knee out doing karaoke. Had to have two surgeries.
Doing karaoke. Oh, my God. I remember there was a kid that did an open mic. I was not this kid, no. But for all my comic buddies that listen, Joe Robinson, you remember this place. Soho Tea and Cafe. The mic was wedged in the stand. And this dude goes to, like, pull it out. And he's trying to, like, talk at the beginning of a set, like... Yeah, so my girlfriend's being a real pain in the ass. I'm like, pow! And blows his front two teeth out. When the mic came out of the stand, it rocketed towards his mouth and just bang, blew both his teeth out. Let's go to... Ooh, I see the word hernia up here. Joe, Baltimore, what's the dumb way you hurt yourself?
Well, the truck driver and the hernia happened when I jumped out of the trailer onto the in the landfill and... gave myself an ingroinial hernia. All I did was jump out of a trailer.
You just jumped down, landed,
just,
completely blew. Was it your gut or your crotch? Which hernia?
Ingroinial, the crotch.
Oh, the crotch one. We're so tender.
How are we at the top of the food chain? I mean, I get that we're smart, but we're just so fragile. I mean, we're just such a...
That's a great point. Does, like, a lion ever pull a muscle?
Yes.
Lions pull muscles?
Does a chimp throw its back out reaching for food?
Yeah.
Oh, man. Gianna sat down to pee last year. Completely blew out my knee. Had to get an MRI. Had to be in a brace for over a month.
Happen?
Completely sober. Just blew her knee completely out, making a number one. Who else we have here? Thomas, trying to take an old toilet seat off, turned into prying off the bolts. I ended up flinging a rusty piece of metal directly into my eye. It started to bleed immediately, off to the emergency room. So stupid. Wow. Let's talk to Michael in Pasadena. My God, I haven't seen the phones this active in months. What's going on, Mike?
The text. I can't keep up with text.
It's amazing.
Either.
What's going on? How'd you hurt yourself in the dumb way?
How you doing,
buddy?
Hey, I was hunting Eastern Shore gun season.
Can't hear a word, buddy. You got to stick about 50 to 60 yards closer to the speakerphone. Let's go back to Eric in Elkton, Maryland. Eric, good morning.
How you doing?
How you doing?
Fine.
Not too bad. So, yeah, I hit myself in the head with a shovel when I was a kid. Okay. And I was launching. I was putting Gatorade bottles in the handle of the shovel. And I stepped on the shovel and put my head down at the same time and stepped on with both feet and then hit myself in the head, pretty much knocked myself out. My dad wasn't there. He actually was inside getting ice, you know, ironically enough, and then came outside and I was laying on the ground and I had a big old golf ball sized weld on the top of my head.
God.
So.
Oh, God, just knock yourself out. Catapulting Gatorade bottles into the woods. I'm hard-pressed to call this one dumb because I can see how you would hurt yourself like this. Pat says he went suicide sledding, whatever that is. I'm not sure if you'd like tie knives to a tree at the base of the hill and hope you land on one. Pat, you'll have to explain what suicide sledding is. You write that like anybody knows. January of 99, I hit a tree with my head going 25 miles per hour, knocked out, shattered teeth. EMTs had to drag me out. The CT tech asked if I was in a car accident. It was the second massive concussion that I had within 6 months, the prior one being high school football. And the phones are completely full again. Yeah, that's a pretty standard way to hurt yourself. Like your chin, Scott. I mean, you blew that open like riding a bike.
Yeah, that wasn't like he wasn't doing anything ridiculous. He actually got hurt.
Sex injury.
Yeah. Whoa, what? Sorry, Josh.
Somebody said that they broke their testicle having sex. They said a testicle was black and blue for a month, and then 10 years later, the pain came back, and he had to have surgery. Sex injury.
How do you – I've heard of penises breaking, but I've never heard of a testicle breaking.
Oh, yeah. Some girl that definitely thinks she's like Lexi Love and knows how to – I can't even say the position, but it involves a cowgirl. And then just like, yeah, you ready for this? Oh, God. And then he sits down on it. Yeah.
It's Josh Spiegel. Remember, there are lots of ways to listen to 98 Rock every day. 97.9 FM, streaming live on 98online.com. The 98 Rock smartphone app on iPhone and Android and on your Amazon Alexa and Google Home. Make sure to follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/98online.